Hi, I'm Michael Correa, and this is Psych Exam Review. This is a practice question video, so we'll be looking at 10 practice multiple choice questions related to stress and health psychology. Before we get to the questions, some reminders on how to use these effectively. And one is to try to come up with your own answer first. So I'll pause after I read the question and before I show the multiple choice options. And you want to use that time to try to think of your own answers. And you might want to pause the video if you need more time to do that. And only then should you look to the multiple choice answers, and you should have a sense of what it is that you're looking for. And finally, make sure that you also review any unfamiliar terms that appear in the question, in the incorrect answer choices, or in the explanation. With all that in mind, let's begin. When John got a raise at work, he felt a brief surge in well-being. But soon, he felt about the same as before, supporting the concept of post-traumatic growth, downward comparison, the faith factor, the hedonic treadmill, social capital. And this would be D, the hedonic treadmill. The hedonic treadmill, or adaptation level phenomenon, refers to our continual adjustment to new positive experiences. New possessions or increases in income can boost happiness, but generally this increase is short-lived. This type of immune cell is able to engulf and then digest pathogens. T cell, macrophage, natural killer cell, Schwann cell, B cell. And this would be B, macrophage. Macrophages, from the Greek big eater, are lymphocytes which can surround and digest cells identified as pathogens, a process known as phagocytosis. The HPA axis refers to the hippocampus, pineal gland, amygdala, hippocampus, putamen, appendix, hardiness, persistence, appraisal, hypothalamus, pancreas, arteries, hypothalamus, pituitary, adrenal glands. And this would be E, hypothalamus, pituitary, adrenal glands. The HPA axis is activated in a stress response, and this refers to the hypothalamus releasing corticotropin-releasing hormone, which causes the pituitary to release adrenocorticotropic hormone, which then signals the adrenal glands to release catecholamines and glucocorticoids. The idea that the body must constantly anticipate and adapt energy use based on context is known as psychoneuroimmunology, homeostasis, allostasis, biofeedback, reappraisal. And this would be C, allostasis. Allostasis, from the Greek variable state, is the idea that the optimal state of functioning is constantly shifting depending on the situation, and the body must constantly adjust across a broad range in order to maintain constant functioning. Meyer Friedman and Ray Rosenman suggested that this trait was associated with greater risk of heart disease. Type A behavior pattern. Type B behavior pattern, resilience, commitment, hardiness. And this would be A, type A behavior pattern. Friedman and Rosenman found that a pattern of ambition, competitiveness, time urgency, and hostility, which they labeled type A, was associated with an increased incidence of heart disease compared to a laid-back type B pattern. The pattern of adopting an external locus of control for our failures and an internal locus of control for our successes is known as John Henryism, self-serving bias, illusory superiority, Dunning-Kruger effect, self-efficacy. And this would be B, self-serving bias. Self-serving bias refers to a tendency to blame external forces for failures and take personal credit for successes. And this may help us to feel good about ourselves and to maintain our motivation. This researcher drank a petri dish of Helicobacter pylori bacteria in order to show it was a cause of the gastritis that leads to peptic ulcers. Suzanne Kobasa, Martin Seligman, Barry Marshall, Hans Selye, Walter Cannon. And this would be C, Barry Marshall. Robin Warren and Barry Marshall were awarded the Nobel Prize in Medicine in 2005 for their 1982 research identifying a bacterial cause for gastritis, though stress still plays a role in the severity of symptoms and the progression of peptic ulcers. Research has suggested a link between PTSD and smaller hippocampal volume, larger hippocampal volume, smaller adrenal glands, an enlarged thymus, enlarged ventricles. And this would be A, smaller hippocampal volume. Research by Mark Gilbertson et al. And Douglas Bremner et al. Suggests that smaller hippocampal volume may be a risk factor as well as a consequence of post-traumatic stress disorder. Dogs given repeated unavoidable electric shocks later showed passivity in the face of shocks that they could escape, known as invisible support, learned helplessness, transference, relative deprivation, learned optimism. And this would be B, learned helplessness. Martin Seligman and Stephen Meyer found that dogs given unavoidable shocks learned to be helpless, and they later passively endured shocks that could be escaped, a pattern that has been replicated in other animals and humans and has implications for the role of perceived control in disorders like depression. Learning to control one's breathing and relax in the face of a stressor would be a way of applying problem-focused coping, appraisal-focused coping, avoidance coping, emotion-focused coping, copium. And this would be D, emotion-focused coping. Emotion-focused coping refers to managing stress by focusing on emotional responses, rather than the stressor itself. And one way that this can be done is by learning to calm our physiological reactions to stress. Okay, so that's the end of these questions. I hope that you did well. I also hope that you found them challenging. Make sure that you review any terms that were difficult or unfamiliar, and share any suggestions or questions that you have in the comments, and I'll do my best to answer them. Thanks for watching.